Okay, so this is a very spur of the moment video. So if I like get off track of what I'm saying, I'm so sorry. It's because I didn't write notes, I didn't think this through. I just literally had this thought and I turned my camera on. So, okay, if you're into manifesting, spirituality, changing your life, all this stuff, then I'm sure you've probably gone through some like sort of awakening, or maybe you've just decided one day that you want to change your life, whatever you want to call it. You are watching this video for a reason. So I wanted to talk about how the universe tends to throw shit in your way when things finally start looking up and what that means. Okay, so have you ever experienced something where things are going your way mentally? You're feeling good and you finally make a decision to change your life in some way. So for me, that was by pursuing YouTube full time and following my dreams of doing different creative things rather than pursuing a corporate job. For some people that might mean quitting your job. For some people it might mean finally taking that program that you've been afraid to tell your parents you want to take because it's, I don't know, musical theater or something and they don't support that. Or it could literally mean anything. It's just you making the choice to change your life and live for you. I feel like when you make the decision, you finally start to step into yourself and do what you love and all those things, the universe will throw shit at you to kind of like test you. Also guys, sorry if you can hear the wind moving through my windows. I have 4 layers of windows, so the wind sounds like ghosts when it's in there, but anyways. So the universe throws shit your way, or that's what it feels like, but really it's your ego. Your ego is working against you. So all of the reasons why you chose not to pursue certain things in your life, such as the musical theater program, being a full-time YouTuber, quitting your job and starting a business, all these things, whatever it may be, all the reasons that you chose not to do that had to do with your ego. But now you've made the choice to change your life and start that small business, but your ego's still here. So your ego is going to get in the way of that, and you have to learn to filter out your ego. Your ego is also considered to be like an energy. So when you are on the path to success and doing what you love, the energy of your ego comes back up and is trying to stop you because that's what your brain is used to doing. Your brain has been programmed this whole time to think, oh, I could never do that program. My parents won't support me. I could never do this, blah, 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 blah. That it just keeps resurfacing. It's something that you have to get rid of before you can truly, truly succeed and follow the path and continue down the path that you want. So this can be things like, for example, last year, I quit my job, I dropped out of school, I moved out of my parents' house and I pursued YouTube full time. No, that was 2019, but anyways. 2019, I made all those big changes and things felt real good for a minute. I was on a high, I was so happy, I was creating so much content, I felt good. And then suddenly just shit hit the fan. Like I started lacking financially. I started to go through heartbreak after my boyfriend and I broke up. My cat died. I've talked about this a million times. Like I've brought it up on my channel, I think 100,000 times. But I'm saying all this to say that like all these things kept happening and it was like the universe was testing me to see how I would handle it. And instead of, you know, overcoming everything and pushing past it and kind of like stepping up and being like, okay, yes, this happened. What can I learn from this? Let me move forward. I fell into like a slight depression for a few months until I finally picked myself up and got myself out of it. But for those like, I think 2 months, I was sinking lower and lower and lower, and I like things just got worse. Like other things in my life went really bad and I fed into my ego and all of those bad things happening, and I let it overtake me. And this is something that you can't do, because when you feel like you're on the right path and you're making a decision for you, things might start happening. I'm telling you right now, it's gonna feel like you're on top of the world, and then all of a sudden, like, you know, I read in this book, the example was given that like you get a parking ticket, or your car is suddenly fucked up and you have to pay a bunch of money, or your computer stops working, or things that just happen that are fucking with your energy. And it's like, are you going to match that low vibrational energy and allow bad things to keep happening? Or are you going to accept them for what they are, either learn from them or move past them and just keep going and prove to yourself that this is the path that you want to take? Because if you are, you know, still ruled by your ego, it's likely that you might fall into that and just say, fuck it. Like, I'm just, you know what, maybe I wasn't meant to do this. Maybe it's a sign that I just shouldn't start that YouTube channel. Maybe it's a sign that I shouldn't create my Etsy business. That's your ego, and your ego is evil. not evil, but you know, your ego is out to get you. Don't fall into that. You need to push past it and continue to move forward, because otherwise your ego will take over and you will continue to live a life that of no abundance, really. So it's something that I wanted to share, because I think a lot of people think woe is me when bad things happen, and so did I, but you can't look at it that way. You gotta look at it like, okay, I must really be making the right decision if my ego is this focused on trying to stop me from this. Like, your ego is not your friend. Your ego is something that you need to recognize and allow things to be filtered in your brain before they can really get to your ego. Do you know what I mean? I'm not even talking like all those situations, I'm talking about in general. Like, you just want to learn to control it and be aware of it so that you can always live in your authentic self. So in the book that I was reading, it says that your ego pretty much creates chaos in an attempt to self-sabotage and keep everything as is instead of moving forward into the unknown yet desperately wanted territory, new territory. So pretty much like what it's saying is like your ego wants to keep you safe in a way. So your ego likes what it knows. And if that is working at Staples 5 days a week for 8 hours a day, then your ego wants to keep you there. It's safe. It wants to be protected. It doesn't want to be rejected. It doesn't want to feel like it failed. It doesn't want to feel like, you know, you tried and gave up. It just wants to keep you where you're at, which is not good. So it will kind of throw shit in your direction. The energy that is aligned with your ego will throw shit in the direction of your path to throw you off and keep you stagnant. And the whole point is you need to overcome it, dodge them, overcome, just move through these things. Otherwise you are going to stay working at Staples 9 to 5 and you're not going to be happy, because you're going towards things that you and your authentic self want and love. And that's all you need to worry about. You just need to focus on what you want and love and ignore your ego and try and get rid of it. It's pretty much just trying to keep you in your old life, and you don't want that. You just gotta give it time and be patient and trust that the universe has your back. It's gonna get frustrating. It will. It will. During that time last year, or like 2019, 2020, the two worst like years of my life, I got so many parking tickets, flat tires, I got my car towed. My computer wasn't working. It was literally things that happened to so many different people that have this experience and go through this journey that I was reading about, and they're all happening to me. I was like, what's going on? Like, why are all these bad things happening? And it took me a long time to realize what it was. And I just felt like, woe is me. Like, why can't I just achieve the things I want? And I just like, I don't know, I felt like I wasted my year focusing on the bad. And I just wanted to make this video so that you guys don't focus on the bad and don't get thrown off course, because like, you can't do that, because then you won't be living the life that you want, and no, that's not acceptable. So I know this video was really short, but I just wanted to share that because I feel like it's something really important that I haven't talked about on my channel at all. And I don't know, I want to start, I guess this is like a manifestation energy spirituality series. I don't really know what this is. I think I'm going to make a playlist of just like my random talks to do with spirituality and manifesting in the life you want. I don't really know how to go about it, but yeah, I just felt compelled to put that message out there to anybody who wants to listen. So I hope you enjoyed this. I know it wasn't like an entertaining video. I hope you guys don't mind when I randomly put these messages on my channel. They're usually not planned videos, so there won't be like fun editing and jokes and that and that, and like, that's okay with me, because I do have two different sides to my personality. So I hope you guys are okay with just like the very simple but powerful videos that I create to do with like spirituality, because when I have a thought, I'm gonna just start recording it, because I feel like when it's fresh in my mind is the best time to get it out there. I hope you enjoy this, I hope you learned something, and please, please, please apply this to your life. Just remember that things are happening for you and not to you, okay? No matter what it is, no matter how bad it seems, things are happening for you and not to you. That is like the main message of this video. So yeah, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.